Well, first of all, it's been a busy week, but let's start with sports betting on Beal. A lot of folks that I've seen on social media have been saying, how do we make this happen? So can Chairman Van Turner, will you explain?
Well, there was a recent decision from the courts which said that it would be legal. I think we also have to travel through maybe a constitutional referendum, perhaps. Mm-hmm. I think that's still being looked upon by the Attorney General. And then finally, the legislature would have to pass enabling legislation to allow municipal governments and counties throughout the state to enact sports betting. We already have the state lottery, and it's funded education. I think we could use the sports betting as well to fund education, to help with infrastructure, and to help out with public safety as far as bringing in blue light cameras to the communities that want them.
And it seems like, to me anyway, the legislature is very open to that. Immediately after the Supreme Court decision earlier this year, there was talk of doing that. So. Mm-hmm. Any concern, though, because it will be isolated to Beale, about crime? We already talk about crime in Beale Street a lot. Any concern about that?
You know, we've got a great police director. I think Mayor Strickland, as well as our county mayor, is very committed to making all of Shelby County safe. I don't particularly believe that sports betting is going to increase any crime on Beale.
Bring any elements in?
I don't. I think those people that want to cause harm to people, that can happen anywhere. Mm-hmm. But I think we're all very committed to being sure Beale is a very safe place for our citizens, for our tourists. And quite frankly, people are going across the bridge and betting across the bridge, as well as
and
going out of Shelby County.
Yeah, so for sure.
At some point, we don't want to lose all that revenue that has really bled out of this community.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Have you talked to establishments down there? I mean, what are they feeling?
Well, we're still hearing from them and to see what they want to say. I would imagine that the testimony that they would render would be most impactful at the state legislature. All we can do is request, but it's going to take the Tennessee General Assembly to pass a bill. So we would hope that the Beale Street vendors would make their way to Nashville and speak with the legislators in Nashville.
Well, speaking of the legislators, you guys frequently have on a list of things what you want. So let's pretend they're Santa and you guys are the kids asking, what do you want from the legislature this year? Who wants to start with that?
Well, Amber Mills, our new Shelby County Commissioner, is our legislative chair. We've put a number of things on the table. BEP funding formula for our school system is a steadfast issue. It's hard to move the needle in Memphis and Shelby County if we cannot improve education.
Right.
I think all of us are committed to seeing that through, but we have to have appropriate funding.
Right,
I think,
and they haven't been real open to that in the past. What are you going to do differently to get more money into this area?
My personal belief is we've got to get more parents and children involved to really speak up. We can speak as legislators, but I think legislators open their eyes when they see children and families who are being affected by the lack of education. We've got to do a better job on that. My hope is that we mobilize the community more to move the legislature for more consideration.
Do you agree? Mm-hmm.
I agree. I certainly do. I think education is key to resolving so many issues within the community. That's first and foremost on our agenda. And so we would be hopefully there in Nashville in the new year asking for more support for education.
And Mr. Turner, before we leave, we have to ask you, you had Green Space, Memphis Green Space, mm-hmm. who is in charge of the parks where these statues were removed. Now there's a lawsuit in the works. Mm-hmm. What's your response to that?
Well, I think that we are committed to doing the right thing. General Forrest's will, his last will and testament, indicated that he wanted to be buried in Amwood Cemetery along with his wife, Mary Forrest. And so we said all the time that we want to honor the last will and testament of General Forrest and honor his wishes. And if that's what the family wants, I think we can resolve to find a way to make that happen. As far as the monuments, we're more than willing to transfer those monuments to Shiloh or to another Civil War Memorial Park in order for our folks to go there and learn about the Civil War. And so we would hope that we could find a resolution with all the parties quickly, and we're committed to doing so.
Well, we certainly will continue to watch that. And I know you probably are reluctant to talk about colleagues down the street, but as you watch what City Council is going through with the appointment of new members, your thoughts?
Well, I think that as legislators, sometimes you have tough issues. We hope that, things will get worked out. The special election, may be a good idea if they're unable to seat those three legislators. And so, but that's a city council issue. We enjoy working with the city council and our city mayor, and so we'll just wait and see what they decide to do.
Van Turner diplomat. Mark, you?
Well, you know, we all serve at the will of the people, and I feel bad, quite frankly, for those citizens in the city of Memphis that currently don't have representation. And there's a lot of work to do in Memphis and Shelby County. So if you're a citizen that's in one of those districts not being represented, I think you've got to speak up and say, I want representation, and I want good representation. It's never good when elected officials are forced to appoint someone. And that's why recently with the opening of Senator Norse's seat, mm-hmm. our body has chosen to defer that mm-hmm. and let the citizens of Shelby County speak. And so ideally, that's what's best for, you know, again, we serve at the will of the people, and you can't forget that.
Citizens need to do more. Thank you.
They've got
to
speak up.
Can't just complain, right?
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas to you all as well.
Thank you. Happy New Year.